This morning in the Rhode Show kitchen, we are joined by Chef Dan Morgan. He is here courtesy of Go Providence. Good morning, Dan.
How's it going today?
Nice to see you, buddy.
Likewise.
You, sir, are from Pamfilio's.
Yes.
Of course. And this morning we are making cider braised pork shank with corn pudding. Is that correct?
Yep.
All right. Thank goodness I got it right. I would hate to say the wrong thing. So this morning, take us through some of the ingredients that you'll be working with here.
So first we'll start with the pork shank. We're going to sear that. Then we're going to add like a mirepoix. That's some celery, onions, carrots, some garlic.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to add a little bit of twist. We're going to add some sweet potatoes because it is fall. So you can do sweet potatoes, turnips, parsnips, all those nice fall vegetables that make it a hearty meal.
Uh-huh.
Some rosemary, some sage. And then for the corn pudding, it's just your basic corn muffin mix.
Mm-hmm.
Some corn, some heavy cream, a little chicken stock, and some sugar.
This all looks spectacular. I can't take my eyes off the wonder that is all of these ingredients laid out on the table before us. Is this one of your favorite things to make, or do you have many favorites? Is this like a fall favorite for you?
Well, right now with the fall, it's like I love braised stuff. Because, I mean, there's so many different things you can do with it.
Mm-hmm.
After it's all said, you can pull it out. You can make a shepherd's pie with the pork. Instead of using a beef, you can be really creative that way. You can pull off the meat when it's all set, mix it with pasta, so you have a different version of, say, a bolognese.
Beautiful.
So instead of using the ground beef, you can use the pork, or if you're doing a short rib, you can do that also.
And now I want a shepherd's pie, I want a short rib, I want it all, Dan, it's what I do. Tell us about Pamfilio's, your location, for folks out there that don't know.
We're in Cumberland on Mendon Road, so tonight, actually, we're starting cooking classes.
Perfect, perfect.
So they start at 6 o'clock, we still have a couple of seats open, and tonight's gonna be like a Tuscan theme.
All right.
So we'll do some pork, a pork loin, some Tuscan clams.
Beautiful. Well, save a chef's coat for me and a hat and save me a spot and maybe I'll be there. I need to learn a few things.
Sounds good.
All right, Dan, thank you very much. This, of course, Dan Morgan from Pamfilio's. He's here all morning long. You don't want to miss what he's coming up with. For now, back to you.
We're in the Rhode Show kitchen. Chef Dan is here. Pamfilio's is the place. We got a cider braised pork shank with corn pudding. So that's what we're doing right now. You got this pan nice and hot.
And the pan's nice and hot. So what I did is I sear the shank. So now I'm going to add the onions, okay. Add the celery. Some carrots, sweet potatoes, some garlic, rosemary, sage. Just gonna let that caramelize for a couple of seconds.
All right. And can we talk about the pork shank itself for anyone out there who may not know, what is the shank?
So the shank is from the kneecap down.
All right.
So it is, it's a really good braising. So it has a lot of gelatin in it, so it adds a lot of flavor.
Mm-hmm.
It's a really good really good piece of meat.
For anyone who cooks out there with pork all the time, do you have to prepare this differently? Do you have to cook this differently?
Well, since it is a shank, so you have to braise it for a long time.
Right.
So usually you add the, like how I'm doing here with the mirepoix.
Look at that. That looks beautiful.
It's got a lot of flavor right there, especially as it sweats. It's releasing the sugars.
So good.
So once this is all sauteed, I want to add some cider to it.
All right.
Some chicken stock.
Mm-hmm.
Some demi-glace. If you don't have demi at home, you could always use some beef gravy. And then right at the end, I want to add a little bit of citrus. So since it is fall, you can start using like a clementine or an orange to add a different flavor. But you definitely want the acidity in it because it's going to bring a nice, robust flavor.
A little tang to it.
So then you just put the shank on there, cover a saran wrap foil, put it in the oven for about 3 to 4 hours. Or if you're doing a crock pot, you could start in the morning when you go to work, come home, and it's all set, ready to go.
And that's a that's one thing. A lot of people out there will see some of these recipes and go, you know, I don't have time to do this. But if you have a crock pot at home.
Yeah, it works perfect.
They work perfectly for anybody who's working all day long. You put this in the crock pot during the day, you come home, that house smells fantastic because you have this going in there. And how long, if it is in a crock pot, should it kind of go
through? I'd say probably between 5 to 6 hours.
All right, so while you're working, throw this in the morning and you're good to go by the time you get home for dinner. And then you've got this perfectly cooked and delicious meal. We're going to taste this. We are going to talk about the restaurant again and all of the other things that we're going to put together here in just a little bit. Back to you. You want a great fall meal for a day like this? Then you have come to the right place. Chef Dan is here from Pamfilio's. We've got cider braised pork shank, corn pudding. This is the meal you want to make today. If you've got time to put this together, perfect for a cold day like this. Remind everyone what we got going on here.
So what we did is we seared the pork, sauteed all the vegetables, added the cider, added the chicken stock, added the demi, covered it, baked it in the oven. So what happens now is all the flavors are going to start really marrying together. And as it does, as the flavors reduce, it's going to create a nice sauce.
I've never gone to the market before to buy a pork shank, so if I go to the butcher, what do I need to look for?
It's just a lot of times you'll have the skins around it. You can get that with it taken off. Really, you just want to look. It has a good amount of fat content because when you're searing it, that's where all that flavor is coming from.
Right.
And just like if you want to do this with an Oscabuco, mm-hmm. or you can do the same recipe too with a pork, beef short rib.
Okay.
It comes out really good.
And really, you were moving this just a little while ago. When you said after having this in the oven for a long time, this will really just completely fall apart.
Yeah. It's going to be hard to handle, but it'll work out good.
All right. And then this right here?
So this is the corn pudding. What this is just some chicken stock, some heavy cream, a mm-hmm. little sugar, some corn, and your basic corn muffin mix.
And that's it.
Just bring it up to a boil. Add the muffin mix in there and just whisk it together. And it's really good also for the corn pudding, or you can make it a little tighter and you could do like a Johnny cake with it.
Okay.
You could put it in the fridge, and after it cools down, you could sear it on the grill or in a pan, like if you got to do it like a polenta.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a little sweet, and it goes very good with the pork.
All right, for anyone out there who doesn't know where the restaurant is itself, let's talk about the restaurant and what you got going on.
So we're located on Menden Road, 1800. Mm-hmm. Like I said earlier, tonight we're starting cooking classes.
Oh, that's great.
So tonight's going to be a Tuscan theme, and something we talked about when I first started there, and everybody was really enthused about it, really wanted to go, so
sure.
we figured. Took a little while to get everything all set, but mm-hmm. tonight's the first one. We have a couple of seats still open, so you can go on our website, check it out, or you can come in the restaurant and book a reservation, or you can even do it online.
I think something like this is great for a lot of people that get stuck in that rut every day where they're going to work, they come home, they throw something together, and it's probably the same old meal that they make week after week after week. And someone who may not know about cooking that much, this is a great way to experience new things.
It's really good too. The holiday season's coming around the corner, and
about wowing your guests with some good stuff.
You know, if it's a gift certificate, or instead of having your typical holiday party where everybody talks and sits around talks, it's something that's interactive where you can learn how to cook and also with your coworkers.
That's really good. I really like that. All right, so this is the finished product. All right, I'm going to step behind you because I'm just going to, let me just scoot over here. We're going to grab a fork out of here. We'll scoot around. I mean, just look at the way this looks itself. Looks perfect with the carrots in here. And the pork is really just falling.
And like I said, too, if you have some left over, you can always make a chili out of it.
Okay.
You can add some pasta and do like a bolognese mm-hmm. with it instead of doing your traditional beef. So it's a really universal product.
And just the smell of it itself is, wow, man, it's just so good. Let's take a little taste of this. Man, that is so good.
Thank you.
So good. Mm. This won't last very long here. All right, talk about some of the other things that are on the restaurant itself.
We also, we signed a new dinner menu. We're in the process of finishing it up right now, so probably the first week of November, we'll go into place, and there'll be stuff offered like the pork shank. We're trying an Italian version of a poo-poo platter.
Okay.
So, different things like that, so, please, everybody.
And the cooking classes themselves that you're running, how can people get involved in these cooking classes? And is each week or each time that you do it, is it going to be a different theme, type of menu?
It's going to be a different theme. Like I said earlier, the first one is a Tuscan theme. The next one we want to do is probably more like a catering for holiday parties.
Right.
And I'll say if you and a bunch of people want to have a certain class on how to braise, how to do barbecue, we could definitely, do a class just for that.
Just for that, too.
Yeah.
All right, good stuff. All right, the holidays are coming. I know we haven't even hit Halloween yet.
Yeah.
Do you want people to call now if they've got a party that they want to have?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Start calling now, and we can custom make different menus for them, or if it's a class they want to do, we can definitely custom make a class for them.
Well, I got to tell you, this is so, so good, and your suggestion about putting it in the crock pot is perfect way to make this for someone who's busy all day working. If you want this recipe, you can head to our website. All you got to do is go to WPRI.com, click on the Roadshow page.